You got this.
Welcome you to this live pay-per-view extravaganza. I'm Joe Tessitore, ringside with Teddy Atlas, and welcome to the New York City Arena here in Midtown Manhattan for tonight's main event. 10 rounds of welterweight action between these two great warriors. He's coming down to the ring now, and what a nice reception as he is completely focused in on his goal tonight. Kermit Cintron's on his way to the ring, and you can just tell what kind of night he intends this to be. He's just brimming with confidence.
Fighting out of the blue corner, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Danger. His adversary, fighting out of the red corner,
all right, guys, we went over the rules in the dressing room. Let's clean break. All right, that's most. Let's go.
Well, they've been waiting for this moment, and now they get it. Round one underway.
Teddy, you just look at the physical stature of these two guys, and it's clear to see one fighter is much stronger than the other. But if you're the fighter who's not as strong, you still got to go out there and win the fight. How do you do it?
Well, first of all, you yell at your manager for making this fight. And then the second thing you do is you make sure that you have good shoes on, good track shoes, and you use them.
Oh,
off to the side. A little swing and a miss going upstairs. Good defense just covering up down low. Parries that punch away. And coming upon the halfway mark of this three-minute round. Well, he's throwing it, but just missed. Isn't landing it. Not able to land the headshot. Blocks that belt line well. Nice job to land that counterpunch and getting away from one of his own by Diesel. Last 10 seconds of this first round. Gets rid of that. It was intended for his head.
Certainly don't stand in front of him. You gotta give me the double jab. You're not giving me the double jab. You only give me one jab at a time, okay?
I'm not gonna stand here and watch you take those shots, you understand me? Let's see some defense and more punches.
Here we go. Round two is underway. His opponent wanted the body. He wouldn't give it to him. Blocks away that headshot. There it is! He is not in good shape. He could be on the deck in moments. Good way to protect him. What a hook to the body, and he is down and in bad shape. Able to get up to his feet. Teddy, what should he be thinking about now?
Well, right now, just surviving, but if he survives, then he better figure out why he was put on the floor.
Blocks that belt line well. Halfway through round number two. Well, we're seeing two guys here tonight do their thing, Teddy, but it's what they do. And for the second time tonight, he goes down. From a big shot, now he's got to have some big guts to move along.
You're going to find out exactly what he's made of.
Devastating blow by Diesel. Holy cow! Just ate a big uppercut. He's in bad shape. Good defensive skill with the block by Diesel. End of this round. Alongside Teddy Atlas, I'm Joe Tessitore. Now they got some work to do here. Their man was just dropped.
Yeah, the first thing is you put some cold water. You can't use that. You clear his head, and you tell him why he was dropped.
All wondering, can he survive the start of this round after the way we saw him go down in that last round?
Well, it's up to his opponent, Liv. Now, his opponent gets a little careless and he rushes in a little bit too close, he could get a chance to grab those hands and tie him up. And then he could kill a little of the clock surviving.
Staying away from those headshots with his defense up top. Gets to him with an uppercut. Oh man, he's in rough shape after absorbing that blow. Nice block. Firing off the uppercuts. Great exchange. Able to cover up along the belt line. Blocks that one. Thought he had his target, but way off to the side with the uppercut. Able to defend and then go on the offensive. Diesel's probably thinking to himself that he found an early answer, the counterpunch doing damage here.
And his opponent's thinking, what the heck am I doing? Am I shadowboxing? Because I'm not finding nothing. But I tell you, if I am shadowboxing, that shadow, it has a little bit of a punch. It's hitting me back.
There it is! Just hit a big uppercut. He's in bad shape. Oh, good exchange there. So the round comes to its conclusion, and it's a round in which our man here, as he heads back, was really tagged pretty solid. So if you're the trainer in the corner, what's your approach?
Well, you know, that's a great question. My approach is that I have to remind him that he's on common ground. He's probably going to think he's in a place where he's never been before, but I'm going to remind him, hey, remember you got hurt in the gym? And then give him something to correct the problem. You know, tell him some technical things that he needs to hear.
So here we are, a new round underway, and in that last round, he got tagged. He got hit pretty hard, Teddy.
Yeah, he did. He got caught. But now, the first thing is, we all know he got caught, but why did he get caught? He has to be able to decipher that in his head. He has to be able to have the answer to that so it doesn't happen again.
And another jab. What guts it takes, what commitment it takes to keep up with this kind of a pace. The action's been nonstop.
Now, the one thing I can tell you is this is where you don't worry about pace. You don't think about pace. Otherwise, you could not be doing what these guys are doing. They're just going round to round.
Oh, very nice. Smart counterpunch there.
Yeah, that's beautiful. You make the guy miss, you make him pay.
Diesel's fighting real smart here on the outside. Diesel's being very efficient right here. I mean, he's just picking his shots. His accuracy is through the roof.
Well, that's one of the talents, if you hope is a talent, of a top fighter, is his ability to pick his shots, to be calm enough to see the opening. He's seeing everything right now.
He tried to nab him up top, but was unable to connect. Right hand over the top. He counters back after denying his opponent's shot. I would assume there has to come a point in this fight where he has to make the commitment to throw the power punches. It's hard to envision a way he's going to win this fight without going down that road.
He doesn't have the confidence to do it. I don't know if he's mentally strong enough to do it. I think he's worried about throwing hard at the guy because maybe in his mind that means the guy is throwing hard back at him.
10 seconds to go in the fourth. Able to defend and then go on the offensive. Diesel's coasting his way towards a victory here. That round comes to an end, and yet another round that you got to mark down on your scorecard for him.
Yeah, the only way he loses now is if he's a glutton. You know those guys, you've seen them, Joe, they're on our crew. They stay at the table too long. They don't know when to push away from the table, you know? Well, he's got to push away from the table right now. If he does that, hey, this is in the bank.
You're not working on anything. You gotta keep working. Deep breath.
Another round. Will it go in another one-way direction? It's been a one-sided fight so far tonight. Good defense upstairs to stay away from that offensive assault. Hermit Cintron's not showing us that he understands just how effective he can be if he went downstairs against his opponent.
Yeah, well, you know what you're saying, Joe? You're taking a peek and you're taking a swipe without meaning at his trainers. Because what he's telling you is he hasn't been taught some of the rudiments of boxing. That when you hurt a guy, you should go downstairs to finish him.
Mistargeted. He tried to nab him up top, but was unable to connect. Hermit Cintron's cut is on the cheek, and you can see that it's bothering him a bit right now. That's something we'll keep our eye on. He returns the favor with a right hand of his own. Halfway through this round. Good job protecting himself. We can see some swelling now around his eye. Turns over the hook after turning away his opponent's shot. Diesel's in control of this fight, Teddy. Sometimes you can just look at it and see it as clear as day. He's ahead on scorecards.
Yeah, I have my head on my scorecard too. But right now, he can't afford to.
Wow! Now look at him. He does not look good on the back end of that hook coming home. Had his target in mind, but just missed. Ten clicks of the talk. Diesel's got things going his way. We've reached the halfway point. I don't know that this is going the distance. It's so one-sided.
If he keeps up this kind of pace and keeps banging that drum, going downstairs to the body and putting those punches together, we will not go to the distance.
Back to fight action as a new round is underway. Of course, in that last round, it was fairly one-sided. He was hit pretty hard, and now he has to overcome that here.
Yeah, you don't have to be Notre Dame to know that. I mean, everybody saw, you know, he got staggered, his knees buckled, did a little dance there. But what you have to really know now is know why you got hit and correct that immediately.
Hermit Cintron's looking like he's not in control right now, Teddy, and I don't think he's been the same fighter since he got tagged earlier in this fight.
No, he hasn't fully recovered. You know, some of those cobwebs, you know, some of those birds are still twerping in his head.
Holy cow! He is damaged badly there. He may hit the floor. He got hit right there, but he also gave one. Solid effort by Hermit Cintron. Oh, what a great ability to recover. Tried to land that upstairs and was off the mark. Keeping his hands up, getting rid of his opponent's offense. Diesel is doing very nicely on the outside here in this fight. Diesel's strategy has been to control things on the outside. And the jab fits perfectly into it.
Yeah, what it's done is it's set up his defense. He's kept his opponent defensive, kept him off balance, off stride. And it's also set up his power shots whenever he's wanted to.
Wow, just sit back in it. He goes down in the later stages of this round. He's going to try to survive it. A knockout, unable to beat the count of 10. For the official word, let's send it up to the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, by knockouts, your winner, Diesel.
Diesel's your winner by knockout victory.
I feel like I just came out of the movie theater, Joe, and I did not expect that ending.
For Teddy Atlas, I'm Joe Tessitore. Thanks for being with us, everyone.
Yeah, hands up. Yeah, hands up. Yeah, hands up. Yeah,
Do the cat walking past your crib, walk in your house. Go in your mouth, chalking you out. With EMS respond units carrying you out. With the slow IV feed, woken the f*** up like a...
Everybody, Joe Tessitore and Teddy Atlas welcoming you to the Staples Center in downtown Los Angeles for tonight's main event. 10 rounds in the welterweight division between these two great warriors. He's coming down to the ring, and you can tell with that zip in his step that he plans on this one being a spectacular evening for him. Bailey's now making his way to the ring, and you can see how focused he is for the task at hand.
Fighting out of the blue corner, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Diesel. And his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, Bailey.
All right, remember, protect yourself at all times. No headbutts, no low blows.
Well, they've been waiting for this moment, and now they get it. Round one underway.
Teddy, in terms of a power punch, we know the taller fighter is going to try to utilize the jab, but in terms of a power punch, what can he get that shorter fighter with?
The uppercut. Boy, oh boy, that can be like putting a cherry on top of an ice cream sundae. Because you know the shorter guy's leaning, he's coming in, he doesn't see that punch till it's too late.
Right hand over the top, he counters back after denying his opponent's shot. Wow! Boy, oh boy, that's tough to take. Lands flush with the two-punch combo by Bailey. And now you're seeing the beard that this guy possesses because he went from stunned and damaged to staying right upright.
Oh, this is like Santa Claus's beard, I'm telling you right now.
Well off the mark by Bailey. A headshot blocked. Able to dismiss his opponent's shot and then comes back with an uppercut. Devastating blow by Diesel. Oh, and he returns fire with a left hand. Last 10 seconds of this first round. There it is! On the receiving end of a big and accurate hook that wasted no time.
I won't see that counter hook. Make him pay for his mistake. Devin throws.
So here we are, a new round underway, and in that last round, he got tagged. He got hit pretty hard, Teddy.
Yeah, he did. He got caught. Now, the first thing is, we all know he got caught, but why did he get caught? He has to be able to decipher that in his head. He has to be able to have the answer to that so it doesn't happen again.
Very clean offense from deep. Oh, that uppercut got him battling. Diesel's coming up big here early on in the fight because he just showed his opponent, hey, listen, you got to be careful. I can counterpunch.
No better way to slow down your opponent. You know, we know the other way you slow him down. You hit him right on the chin and you make him say, hey, I don't want to walk in. But when you make a miss and you counter, that slows him down too.
Wow! Now look at him. He does not look good on the back end of that hook coming home. There he goes with the right hand again. That's a good block by Diesel. 90 seconds to go here in this round. What's the proper way to use a heavy back, Teddy?
Well, to be aware of all facets of all dimensions, all elements. First of all, where you're punching from. Don't just get in there and just punching because nobody's punching back. Punch from the right distance. When you're jabbing, be at a distance where you can get full extension, where when you throw it, he can't counter you with a right hand. That's very important. And then moving after your last punch, not just taking a picture after you throw because nobody's throwing back. Make believe somebody's throwing back at you.
That's a forceful two-punch combo by Bailey. Accuracy an issue there. Didn't land that straight right hand. Just 10 seconds to go here in the second round. What a good counterpunch by Diesel. Diesel's got things going his way right now. He was able to stun his man in that last round. Teddy, I get the sense he may be able to get him down in the upcoming round.
Well, I have the sense that he may want to start going to the body a little bit because he's hurt him in the head, but he's hanging in there. The body might finish the job.
Fine. I need you to move your head off side to side. Get on that now.
Back to fight action as a new round is underway. Of course, in that last round, it was fairly one-sided. He was hit pretty hard.
And now he has to overcome that here.
Yeah, you don't have to be Nostradamus to know that. I mean, everybody saw, you know, he got staggered, his knees buckled, did a little dance there. But what you have to really know now is know why you got hit and correct that immediately.
Wow! He gets to him with an uppercut. Oh, man, he's in rough shape after absorbing that blow. Able to dismiss his opponent's shot, and then comes back with an uppercut. Blocks that punch. Oh, he just hit a big uppercut right there. He had no idea it was coming his way. He does not look good at all. Tucks those elbows in, blocks the body shot. Oh, that's gotta hurt. Haley's in a bad place right now. He was tagged. Oh, he's hurt. He was hurt right there, but now he's grabbing on like it's a life preserver.
And he's going to have to stay there if he's going to get through these rapids.
Just 10 seconds to go in this round. And a well-placed combination by Bailey. Diesel's got that look. He's got that look like, hey, I know exactly why I had success in that last round. He was able to stun his man, Teddy.
Yeah, you can see that confidence, that body language. Now it's up to an adjustment from his opponent.
Starts up again, but it's only favored one man. Hard to see this fight going the distance based on what we've witnessed so far. That was a miss by Bailey. Teddy, you've been in this spot before as a trainer. Your fighter gets rocked, and then you got to make a decision. Do we stick with the game plan, the style, the way that we were, or do we make a complete adjustment? Which way do you go?
Well, the first thing is, obviously, you make sure the guy's all right to send him out there. Then when you send him out there, you better send him out there with something. You know, you don't send the guy out into the cold with no coat on. So you better send him out there with some advice. You definitely make a change so he can feel confident that it's not going to happen again. You make an adjustment.
And you can see he's done just that. Nothing there on the punch by Bailey. It is unbelievable to sit back and just watch what these guys are willing to give and to take. Wow, what a fight so far.
Well, give and take, that's the key word. Sometimes you're forced to become great. And right now, each one of them are forcing the other to go to great places.
Diesel's doing really well on the outside utilizing his jab. Well, the quick read on this guy, if you watch this fight so far, is that he just doesn't jab enough.
And that's the most basic thing in the world. You need that punch to make everything else happen.
Good-looking counterpunch. Not hitting his mark there going upstairs. Great fight. I mean, just a great fight. Both guys giving their all back and forth.
It doesn't get much better.
Very nice job landing that counterpunch, getting away from one that was coming at him. Diesel's got to find a way to take what he just did in that last round and keep that kind of energy moving forward here, because I do believe he's ahead on the scorecards in a close fight, very close fight.
Yeah, I see it about the same way, but you just said it. It's very important that his corner people now don't really tell him that he's ahead. I think they let him think that if he's not behind, it's a dead even fight, and keep pushing. Keep pushing right there. Stay responsible, stay within yourself, but keep pushing.
Back to action here at the start of this round. That last round was very interesting because It was the kind of round that can turn a fight in a completely new direction. He did well.
Yeah, you know, the old time saying was bad start, good finish. Well, that's what he's hoping for, good finish.
Does it surprise you that he's not going to the body as much as he could be?
Well, what surprises me is that he doesn't have the intuitiveness, you know, just the instinct to understand, to recognize the situation. That's part of the ability of a good fighter, to recognize what he should be doing in a certain situation. He's not seeing that. He should be going downstairs.
He just missed that shot up top. Still plenty of time to work here in round number 5. Minute and a half to go. Wow, is he defensively sound. How about that? Another right hand. Nice block by Diesel. That's a forceful two-punch combo by Bailey. His opponent wanted the body. He wouldn't give it to him. Tucks those elbows in, blocks the body shot. Coming to the end of round number 5, last 10 seconds. You can see he's trying to score up top, but off the mark there. This has been a very entertaining fight. A little time to reflect here at the end of this round. My thoughts being this. I would really be surprised if we go to a decision here. It just has that kind of feel to it.
Yeah, it has a feel to me like going to one of those places where you can eat all the pasta you can for one price, you know? And some guys get carried away. They eat about 5 bowls. Well, these guys, they're going to have a stomachache at the end. Somebody is going to wind up not standing at the end.
Anticipate his punch, okay? Get the car press on.
Are underway for what is the second half of this fight. Who knows what we're in store for? Good job protecting himself. Oh, that's gotta hurt. Diesel's hurt by a big shot. Nice block by Bailey. Well off the mark by Bailey. Gets rid of that. It was intended for his head. And a well-placed counter by Diesel. Boy, the judges are having an easy time with this because this is clean and effective punching we're seeing out of him.
Hey, Joe, remember when you were a kid, your mother or father bought you that painting by the numbers?
Oh, I love that.
He's punching by the numbers.
This is great stuff. I mean, great stuff. Bringing it every which way they are.
Joe, you remember the time you were on a vacation, you saw that perfect sunset?
Oh, yeah.
It was just beautiful. This is beautiful.
Oh, Bailey's in a bad place right now. He was tagged. Able to cover up that gut. He was stunned, but now he's surviving. And a sharp counter punch by Bailey. Not hitting his mark there, going upstairs. Holy cow! Counter punch up top. Diesel's doing an extraordinary job of never giving his opponent the chance to get back in this fight. Just like we saw in that last round there, he's way up on your score.
Yeah, I have way up, and more importantly, you touched on it. It's the kind of fight he wants. You know, it's in his element. It's in, sort of in his pool, so to speak, his waters. You know, it's an outside fight. It's a jabbing fight. Everything he likes.
As another round gets underway, it gets us thinking, how much more of this will we see? Hard to envision this fight going the distance with how lopsided it's been. Accurate counterpunch by Diesel. Bailey,
he's got no head movement whatsoever. I mean, this is a very easy target to hit here.
No, if it wasn't for his opponent snapping his head back with his jab, there'd be no head movement at all. But that's not the kind of head movement that you're talking about. He should be doing it on his own, getting away from the punches. But, Joe, if you haven't been taught it, it's not going to show up suddenly the night of the fight.
Good defense, just covering up down low. Diesel's doing a nice job being comfortable on the outside. You know, I wonder if he's taking his man lightly because he is up on the scorecards, but you can see that he is being pressured and pushed.
You know, he's in there with a real solid guy. I don't think he's taking him lightly. It's just that he's in there in the kind of waters he's never been before, deep waters, and he's swimming harder than he's ever had to swim before.
Good job with another left hand. He just missed that shot up top. I really don't like the way he looks right now, Teddy, and I haven't since he got rocked earlier. Now, physically, he may have overcome that, but to me, he's just going through the motions right now.
Yeah, right now, he's doing just enough to lose. He's fighting very tentative, and he has to get rid of that attitude immediately.
You need to make a mistake, okay? I want to see that counter hook. Make it pay for it. Almost done. You had it, that round.
They are back to action here, but that action has only favored one man, completely one-sided. Hard to see the scorecards coming into play here with how dominating he's been. Not what he was looking for. That's a miss right there. Oh, an explosive headshot there. He is down. From a big shot, now he's got to have some big guts to move along.
You're going to find out exactly what he's made of.
Tucks those elbows in, blocks the body shot. Reaching the halfway mark of this round. There's an excellent combination by Diesel. Now, this is just beautiful to watch. Watch how he just links one to the next, Teddy. A beautiful sequence, almost like musical notes being played.
Well, exactly. It's a nice tune because it just follows. One, as you said, follows the other. Nice and smooth.
One hook deserves another. Wow. Straight right was lined up, but he missed. Wow, is he defensively sound?
You need to capitalize on his mistakes. I want to see that counter talk. Make him pay for his mistakes. This is what it hurts.
Let's get on that smoke.
are all wondering, can he survive the start of this round after the way we saw him go down in that last round?
Well, it's up to his opponent. Now, his opponent gets a little careless and he rushes in a little bit too close, he could get a chance to grab those hands and tie him up. And then he could kill a little of the clock, survive.
Accurate counter punch by Bailey. Bailey's basically doing exactly what we've always seen out of him, and that's after he's been knocked down and affected in this fight.
Yeah, you know, there comes a time you have to make adjustments. That time has come for him.
Well done that time, landing the counter punch. Able to dismiss his opponent's shot, and then comes back with an uppercut. Teddy, this is one of those moments where you just wish you could pick up the phone and call up the world and say, tune in. Everybody should be watching this, right?
I have a cell phone. I might do that right now.
Start dialing. Straight right was lined up, but he missed. Cover up that gut. What a good war this has been. What a good, good, solid fight it's been. The kind of fight that tells me somebody wants to get rid of the other guy.
It almost looks like they made a deal where neither one could win by decision, where if they didn't win by knockout, it doesn't count.
No turning back now. 10th round is upon us. Last round of the fight. Oh! Bailey's in bad shape. Nice block by Bailey. He was able to get up and continue on last time. Now he goes down again. To get up to his feet. Teddy, what should he be thinking about now?
Well, right now, just surviving, but if he survives, then he better figure out why he was put on the floor.
Good block there by Bailey. Well off the mark by Bailey. He needs to improve that accuracy. Missed with the headshot. Covers up nicely, gets rid of his opponent's body shot. He was looking for. That's a miss right there by Bailey. Teddy, I have a very strong feeling as to what you would say if he walked back to your corner, because he's not doing any body work against a fast fighter.
Well, first of all.
Oh, Bailey's legs look shaky. He was hurt. Wow, crushing blow upstairs. Diesel's gonna have his hand raised by way of KO. The 10 count reaches his opponent out. He's the victor. Diesel's your winner by impressive knockout victory.
And he did it just the way he had to. Stayed on the outside and used those quick hands all night.
For Teddy Atlas, I'm Joe Tessitore. Have yourself a great evening. This is what you train for. This is what you train for. This is what you train for.
what you train for. This is what you came for. This is what the sold out seat scream. Show them at the belt. You don't really want to rumble, see? Stick and move, Robert Weaver. Keep your hands up. If you're not down, shake it off and stand up. Counter punch, winniness is let your hands fly. Hit them hard, get your cut, man, on standby. And keep your footwork tight like karate, bro. Fake them with the hook and then shake them with the body blow. Put them on the ropes, keep backing them up. Put your flavor on it, hit them with your flashiest stuff. The fans cheer, cause it's clear, he ain't matching it tough. Show them why they saying that you got a platinum glove.